Hi, I'm Linda, creator of information about arthritis. If you are new to this channel, then don't forget to subscribe. Just click the subscribe button below and then click the notification bell to receive notifications of new videos when they are released. Also, don't forget to visit my website, Food with Arthritis, where you can find out more about these terrible diseases and download free articles. This video will show you how rheumatoid arthritis and multiple sclerosis are similar. The immune system protects against infection. But when you have an autoimmune disease, your immune system turns against your healthy tissues. Rheumatoid arthritis attacks the healthy cartilages of your joints, and multiple sclerosis attacks your healthy central nervous system. With multiple sclerosis, your central nervous system becomes inflamed, and your nerves will become damaged over time. It's done by the protective layer called myelin, which interrupts the signal from going through. When you have multiple sclerosis, the disease can make you have aches all over the body, which could leave you with fatigue, and your muscles will become stiff. As a result, you may lose your balance when you stand or walk. You could also feel sensations like tingling or numbness. Your speech will become impaired as well, and may get sexual dysfunction. With multiple sclerosis, you could have secondary pain in your joints. You may become weak and lose energy. In later days, you may have spasms of your muscles. The pain in your joints may occur around your hips, back, and legs. To manage your pain, some home remedies could help you get through the day. It would help if you did light exercises like walking or swimming each day. Find a local yoga class. This will help stretch your muscles. When you can't get comfortable in a chair, you could use cushions, heat packs, or a hot water bottle is good if you have pains, as heat opens up the blood vessels that help the blood flow better, and ice packs is used for flare-up or swelling. This reduces any bleeding in the tissues. Another thing is that you must stop smoking and vaping. If you happen to be overweight and not eating healthy, you should think about managing your diet better. See my videos on Mediterranean diet and the DASH diet at the end of this video. The last one is to ask your doctor if you can see a physical therapist. When you have multiple sclerosis, your nerves get overstimulated, which means the medication you may be given are anti-epileptic drugs to help with the spasms, seizures or epilepsy. Or another one is tricyclic antidepressants. This one helps with your depression. Opioids could be prescribed if your disease becomes severe, as it's a strong painkiller. But this is not generally recommended, as it is not really effective for treating multiple sclerosis. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs is another one. It's used to treat your joints and muscle pain. Rheumatoid arthritis is an inflammatory disease that causes pain, swelling, and stiffness in the joints, and can also affect your organs like your lungs or heart. And it could be even your eyes. When the joint gets inflamed and damaged, the joint tissue causes chronic and long-lasting pain. The joints that these disease attacks are mainly the hand, feet, and wrist. When you have rheumatoid arthritis, you may have side effects that include both sides of the body can be attacked and more than one joint. You could also feel your joints becoming stiff, tender, and swelling. You may lose weight and get feverish or weak, or fatigue and tiredness. In some cases, this disease can develop over a couple of days, but it usually develops over time. You can manage rheumatoid arthritis with some remedies like acupuncture, a traditional Chinese medication where they use very thin needles to a specific point on your body, but you should go and see your doctor and get a proper professional to do it. Also, get a professional if you prefer a massage. It's a natural method of reducing pain. Exercises are also good, as it keeps your joints moving. All you need to do is just light exercises like swimming, walking, gentle aerobics. You could also buy heat or cold packs, or even a hot water bottle. When you get stressed, you can calm down with deep breathing exercises, or even doing some meditation can help. But with these, you must speak to your doctor when you change your pain management. Like all arthritis, rheumatoid is incurable. However, the medication that you may prescribe could help to reduce inflammation and relieves your pain. The damage to the joints will be slowed down, and your mobility will become better. You may have two types of drugs prescribed to you, both called disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. These releases chemicals when your immune system is attacked. Some DMARDs that could be used are methotrexate. Sulfasalazine is just two, there are many more. You may also be prescribed painkillers. I take a clear gel called Fenbid, an ibuprofen family that I rub on, or could be non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs for your inflammation. Your doctor could prescribe steroids for the pain, stiffness, and inflammation. The similarities between these two are that they are both disabling autoimmune diseases. They both cause chronic inflammation by an overactive immune system. The symptoms are similar, both make you tired and weak. But in different ways, the medication you will be prescribed will be similar, as the symptoms have inflammation and pain and overpower the immune system. The difference is where the disease affects your body. Rheumatoid arthritis attacks the joints. In multiple sclerosis, it affects the nervous system like your brain and spinal cord. Multiple sclerosis can have problems with your vision. You could feel numbness and tingling, muscle spasms, and your muscles become weak and stiff. Your sexual life may become an issue, and with rheumatoid arthritis, you will get pain in more than one joint. Your joints will become stiff, swollen, and tender to touch. The joints affected will be on both sides of the body, for example, both thumbs. You will also have a fever, fatigue, and irreversible joint damage. And lastly, you may have unexplained weight loss. But before you take on any exercises, diets, or anything else, it would help if you saw your doctor. I hope this video has helped, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and receive notifications when new videos are released.